Yeah. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Say hi, everybody. I fell down yesterday and scratched my nose, see? Now you look like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Huh? What's up? Huh? Alright, let's watch something else. I think you're over this.
No.
Hold on real quick. Oh, you want to ride the wheels on the bus? Go round and round? Oh, see? You want to watch that? Get up out of here. But yeah, going back to what I was saying, right? Like we all growing, right? Everybody growing, everybody finding themselves, everybody figuring themselves out. And I think that's the best part about life right now. Now, like I said, I've learned over the past, I don't know, 5 or 6 years. Change what you see, change what you speak about, change what you talk about, change who you talk to, and I promise you, life will literally become easy for you. Change what you see, change who you talk to, change. I promise you, life will become easier for you. Don't tell me to talk about something. I hate when somebody tell me to talk about something. That's not how the world work, bro. I don't get on here and be like, well, hey, I'm going to talk about this specific thing today. Bro, I just let my mind run. Whatever it come, I don't write no notes. You know this, every nigga got notes and shit, man. I'm not writing no notes and nothing. I just let my mind go. These are my thoughts. If you want to talk about something, bitch, go live and talk about it with your couple of 5 or 10 friends that you got. You probably have more friends if you had a real account. Oh, God damn. Said he taking pictures like this and shit. You might have some real friends. Dumbass nigga. Oh, God. You go to his Instagram page. He like this on every picture. God, you might have some real friends. Weirdo. You steady want to talk about portals all day, bitch. Oh, God, bitch. Get out the portal one time. Go to the real world. You steady want to hop through portals and shit. Hey, baby. Hey, Daylyt, you want to talk about portals? Yeah, man, I'm inside a portal. Damn, portal, look at that. Jeez. My mama, yo, these niggas be weird, bro. You know what's the number one DM I get? The number one DM. Yo, they like, could you cover masturbation addiction? Sheesh. Oh, God, you niggas horny. And I get so many DMs about that. Yo, they like, please, I need help. Bitch, get a girlfriend. Sheesh. My mom, I get hundreds of messages about that. Yo, Daylyt, could you cover, I'm 17, could you cover masturbation addiction? Yeah, bitch, outside. You ever heard of the mall? Bitch, you ever tried to bust a bitch one time? Shit, damn, go bust some. You don't know what bust a bitch is? You don't know what that means? Oh my God, this generation is lost. I just said, you better get your bitch ass outside. What up, Clack? Mom, you don't know what bust a bitch is? He talking about, what is that? Oh, my God. It's over for you, cuz. He told me, I need help, Dave. All right, look, man, I got a plan for you. You live, where you live? He said, I live in Georgia. So you live in Atlanta, Georgia. You live in Atlanta, Georgia, you got a jack-off happy. He said, G, it's just, it's something that I just can't. I said, look, G, on God, I want you to take 40. Look, this is what I need you to do. I need you to take $40. Oh God, go buy, use $10, go buy you a fresh white tee. Look, hear me out, G. Go buy you a fresh white tee. On God, use the other 20 to buy like a nice little jacket. On God, because we in the era where people don't really care what it is. On God, if it look drippy, people don't really care what it is. As long as it look like a drip. God, look, so go buy you a bunk ass jacket for 25. Go buy you a fresh white tee. You got some jeans you can wear, on God. Bam. Bam, I know you got some shoes. So boom, hit the mall. On God, it's the big mall right there in the middle by the Waffle House. That's it. Look, hit the mall. Bam, you see a little piece, get up on her, man. Don't do no weird shit neither. He said, what do you mean? What should I do? I said, you really don't know how to bust a bitch. All right, look, man. Look, I sent him a video. I said, this is what you do. All right. Before you even bust a bitch, you got to automatically hunch your shoulders and turn your head to the side like that. He said, how? I said, look, I mean, dude, I had to do a full tutorial. On God, I sent him the video. I said, look, when you see a bitch walk by, you got to go, that's, damn, look at her. Hey, check it out, mommy. That's what you got to say. If that don't work, on God, you got to go to plan B. But you got to try that at least one time. It's a confidence booster. Check it out, mommy, what you on? If she, you know, it's all, you gonna get three different answers. You gonna get, I'm coolin' G. If a girl say she coolin' G, oh yeah, keep walking. Y'all about to smoke and all type of shit. Oh God, she'd do anything for the 40. If you say, what you on, mommy? And she reply to that and is willing to have conversation, oh God, she'd do anything for the 40. But no, 9 times out of 10 you gonna get this. Right? If she do that, that means she high key whack. She wants you to keep trying. If you do that to a real one, she gonna tell you, well, that's not how you talk to a lady. So that's the one you looking for. You looking for the one that says that's not how you talk to the lady. So look, if you say, what's the deal, mommy? And she reply, that's not how you talk to a lady. You gotta go, pardon me. Actually, I knew that was a possibility for me to use my vocal projection to get you to stop to me and have a formal conversation. So, hello, my name is Cedric. I'm actually a construction worker. I work on modern houses and buildings and things like that. What do you do for a living? Oh, God, you gotta switch up ASAP. Oh, God, you can't be scared, G. My mama, you got to go into plan B. Oh, God, you got to go into plan B ASAP. Got to go into plan B ASAP. Blah, blah, blah. Hello, how you doing? She talking about, wait, what? Now you got her in the whirlwind. She like, damn, he really got me to stop and talk to him. Whole time, she lying. She really a thought, but she just wanted to talk. And, oh, God, girls be having game. She talking about, that's not how you talk to a lady. Whole time, she in her head like, bitch, this nigga might get it for the 40. Oh, God, girl. You know how niggas be lying to try to be better? Girls be lying, too. Oh, God, this be an epic lie going on in the beginning. Oh, God. Y'all be lying like, but what you old G? Hey. It be an epic lie going, that's all it is. It be a lie going back and forth. Talking about, that's not how you talk to a lady. Oh, God, she just left the strip club. Oh, she'd have been sending twerk videos all day. She an Instagram thought of that. That's not how you talk to later. You know? All right, well, just let you know, I will ask for your number, but I'm not sure, like, if you will be comfortable with that. So, you know, maybe we could keep in contact via social media. She like, you know, I don't really give my socials out like that. You're like, well, maybe I just DM you or I don't know, you know, something. She like, well, I'll give it to you. on God. So you like, all right, I'm going to follow her back. On God, you go to the social media, you type it in, it's private. You shouldn't. If somebody got their page private, something wrong. Anybody who got their page private, something going on in your life. You ain't living right. Hey, get your butt from over there, dog. That's real shit. If your page rock, no, you ain't living right. Say it. No, your shit ain't private to keep your energy away from they. Man, you a demon. Say it, talk about my shit blocked to hide my energy. What's good, Weezy? What's the deal, Mafia? Say it. Talk about my shit private. The black bitch, your shit private because you got demons following you. Oh God, if you got demons following you, then you a demon. Oh God, the deep. When your energy right, oh God, demons don't even come on the set. And when your shit right, the demons won't even come. Oh God, they ain't gonna do nothing but look. You talking about my page blocked. Bitch, you got 4 followers. Who the fuck checking you out? Oh, let me see. Oh, God, I'm about to go to her shit. Talk about me. Yeah, my page blocked to keep my energy. You got 5 followers. Ain't nobody coming to see you. Oh, God, you better open that thing up. Oh, say you got 25 followers talking about my shit blocked because people be watching. Who? Oh God, this is all about my shit private because people be watching. I'm just saying, you got 20 followers, man. Ain't nobody trying to spy on you. Oh God, I'm just saying. Hey, on some real shit, you ever be scrolling through the grams, you get a message from a one, you be trying to look at the little display picture like, is she bad or not? Oh God, I forgot to follow back. Oh God, you can't see it. You go to the page, it be blocked like a book. Man, oh God, I'm not following her to just see this. My mom, you ever follow one just to, like, but you know you gonna unfollow it? You got all intentions to unfollow it, but you follow it just to get a quick little look. Oh God, what time I follow one page? Man, it be let me scroll it down for an hour. Yeah. I know she got a body shot in there somewhere. God, I think it was scrolling for. Man, she steady taking pictures like this for at least hundreds of them. I know she got. You know, you look at a nit bitch like upper body and be like, she might be thick. Oh God, I could tell that she got like thick girl shoulder. Oh God. I need to be scrolling. Oh God. Man, I know you got one body picture in there. Sheesh. Unfollow. Oh God. I ain't gonna lie, I be following so many people, I just don't follow people with block accounts. I don't even reply to people with block accounts. You know how many people be hitting me in the DM? I don't even reply to people with block accounts. If I see your message and it be something interesting, I'd be like, this is an interesting thing. I might reply. When I go to your page and your shit private, nope, I don't want none of your demons. You're not about to open them demons. When you try to request somebody got a block page and then you open their shit up, there's like an STD. I don't want none of your demons. Creepy ass, hider ass nigga. You want to hide from society ass. Man, I had a nigga hit me your day like, how I get out in the world from an artist. Bitch, your page blocked, first of all. The fuck you mean how you get in the world as an artist? Bitch, your page is private. How the fuck you want people to see you? Oh God, his shit private. It's talking about for booking, for booking and shows and contact something to Gmail. Bitch, who the fuck is gonna book you? They can't see nothing. Oh God. My nigga, your page blocked. Who the fuck is gonna book anything they can't see? He talk about I'll be keeping my shit private because the snakes be watching. My nigga, you got about 2 snakes. Oh God, you got 14 followers. My nigga, ain't nobody watching. Fuck you, be. Look, my nigga. I'ma keep it all the way trillion with y'all. I'ma keep it all the way trillion with y'all. My nigga. You think somebody watching you on Instagram going, niggas be having imaginary problems. You think somebody watching you on Instagram is going to affect you? You think people watching you is going to bother you? Man, you don't open your goddamn Instagram up. God, people be having drama. Look. You can't tell me this because I understand the world on so many levels. You got drama. Your page blocked, you got drama. And if you don't got drama, you a drama creator. It's either or. Or if your page blocked, your page could be blocked for another reason. Especially like certain individuals. Right? Certain individuals like might be going through some legal shit, yada yada yada, boom, shit like that, yada yada yada. But on the we talking about random people who ain't doing nothing. Oh, God. If your page blocked, you got demons. Especially girls. Oh, God. My page blocked, bitch. I don't want his ex-girlfriend all on my page. Bitch. Oh, God. Man, I'm not replying to none of you niggas. You niggas got problems. Sick. I'm not replying to none of you niggas. You niggas got problems. Oh, God. You niggas got problems. Your page blocked. You got a problem. You got drama. You got a lot of drama going on. That's why I don't reply. People stay in the DM. Yo, Daylyt, please help me. G, oh God, man, how I'm gonna help? I don't even know what you look like. How I'm gonna help you when I don't even know what you look like? Oh God, your display picture like this. Oh God, your display picture like this and your page block. Who the fuck am I helping? I don't even know who the fuck I'm talking to. Shit. My mama, you niggas with this Travis Scott mentality. Oh God, I didn't know what Travis Scott looked like until like last week. Oh God, he took pictures like this for 90% of his career. Oh God, Travis Scott be like that. Oh God, damn, Travis Scott, you scared of the world, insecure ass. Mama. But no. Look. Look, man. Look. I'm gonna tell you a valuable thing in life. You ain't gonna find too many answers in no nigga. You know you gonna find all the answers at inside yourself, dog. And the more and more you hide yourself from this world, the more and more you gonna be in the fucking dark, man. More and more you hide yourself from this world, the more and more you have that fake ass bubble that you try to live in, and people, man, you ain't gonna find no truth until you go within inside yourself, bro. Hey, get your butt out of here. Oh, over there, go. Here, hit him on. Pick it. Oh, you don't want them, huh? Where's your water? Go get your water. Go get your water. Hurry up. Go get your water. Go get your water. Hurry up. No, like, you ain't gonna... Look, we talked about this earlier. The problem with life in general is society has trained us to try to live vicariously through other people. Hear me out. It has trained us that, okay, I'm going to try to be like this person, or if I don't reach this person, my life is over. You know how many people, live like that? Like, if I don't meet this person, or this person don't help me, or this, it's over. A lot of people live like that. Motherfuckers be hitting me up all the time. Yo, Daylyt, man, I just got to meet you in order for my life to continue. What? My nigga, you niggas keep forgetting I'm from Watts. You weird. Yeah, I'm conscious and woke and all that, but you weird. Oh God, you don't gotta meet me so your life can continue. Oh God, you just trying to get close to a nigga. Energy vampire ass nigga. Yo, Daylyt, I would love to come chill. For what? I want to come chill and soak up game. Bitch, you know how many blogs I dropped online? Thousands. Oh, shit. Bitch, that's all the game you need. Oh, God. Yeah, day I just want to soak up game. Oh, God. Look, my nigga. Bruh, fuck you mean soak up game, bitch? Oh, God, it's too much. What you mean you want to come chill? Oh, the set. Look.
Look. Please.
What do you mean?
Look.
Oh, God, it's hundreds of thousands of videos. Thousands. Oh, God. What do you mean you want to come chill? What are you talking about? Man, you don't sit your ass on Instagram somewhere and go read some shit. Oh, God. Look, I'm going to tell y'all something. A lot of y'all niggas come to me for advice and help and all that shit, but y'all never ask one question. It's one question y'all never ask. It's one question y'all never ask. Everybody, yo, they like this, that, yo, they like, but just one question y'all never ask. Yo, they like, how did you find yourself? That's a question y'all never ask. I found myself by going within. I was like, y'all, I went through it all. Oh, God, I was a Hebrew Israelite for a minute. Oh, God, I had my Yu-Gi-Oh outfit in the room. On the set, I went through all the things following people. I did it all. I went through all the steps. All the steps following all. Oh, God, I was Christian. I said, all right, I'm out of here. Oh, God, I was a Jehovah Witness. I used to walk up and down the street on Saturdays with the suit on. Oh, God, knocking on doors. Got up out of that. Oh, God, got on my herbalist life meditative type of shit. Got up out of that. That was bullshit. Oh, God. Went back to my Hebrew Israelite. We Hebrew Israelites. And we need to know that we're the children of Judah. And all that extra shit. Oh, God, got up out of there. Oh, God, got in my Muslim bag for a couple of years. Got up out of there. Oh, God. Then, oh, God, man. Then I realized, man, I can't follow these bunk-ass trends. I gotta go within. You know what I did? I asked myself a question. And it's a question that nobody asks. Because, oh God, we all got a voice in our head, but you don't really, you be ignoring that voice. I asked myself, I said, hey, man. God or whatever you want to call yourself, I need an answer, man. What I'm supposed to do? And my mind answered it for me. It said, man, on Gio. My mind answered it for me. Man, on Gio, you weird. My mind really answered it for me. And God, don't come to me asking me no stupid ass questions, dumbass nigga. You weird. You study doing all the Hebrew Israelite shit and all that. You a weirdo. God, man, if you don't get your bitch ass out in the world and rap. Oh, God, sometimes the Most High will give you a clean reality check in the language that you understand. Because sometimes people be waiting for magical blessings. But, oh, God told me like a real nigga. Man, oh, Gio, you better stop asking me these dumbass questions. Man, you know what you're supposed to do in the world. Oh, God, you better get it out there and use your voice. I said, you right. I'm smart. I've been hiding my smartness. I've been trying to hide it, trying to fit in with the homies and all that. I've been hiding it. What's the deal, Mafia? What's the deal? God, man, why am I saying that? Hey, how you doing, sir? Hope you're doing good today, my peoples. So I realized two things in life. I said, I could go and be a big Beezy route. I could go that route to all the homies. Or I could be like a Ziggy. God, y'all don't know these people. I'm gonna show you my big homies. These my big homies. These niggas I look up to in the hood. Show y'all. Oh, these the big homies. And it's crazy because shit in Spanish and all type of shit. Damn, they don't even got the scene. But anywho, you know the scene with them niggas in the alley? And he shot the crackhead. Then after he shot the crackhead, the police came. All them niggas in the background. A lot of my big homies in that background scene. I can't find the whole scene. Anywho. So, in my neighborhood, right? We had a few niggas that was once regular niggas. But then they woke up. And I noticed when these niggas woke up, the hood didn't necessarily outcast them. But they didn't become big figures in the hood. So, in my neighborhood, Ziggy, and especially a guy that I looked up to, his name Poogie, but he go by Savage Beast now. But when I was younger, I looked up to him, not from what he knew, but because he's a basketball player. And remember when I said it in one song, like I was like, it's a nigga better than Jordan, right? When I say Savage Beast, when I say Pookie was better than Jordan, he's better than Jordan. I swear to God, he's the best basketball player I ever seen. On God, you know how you shoot the ball, you hold the button too long? He could shoot like that. On God, he could hold the button for a long time. You couldn't block him. When he did his fadeaways, on God, he'd be in the air for a dummy long time. You just couldn't block him. So I always, if you from where I'm from, you know in our younger days, Pookie was an animal on the court. Animal. So when we got older, on God, he grew his dreadlocks out. That was the first sign I remember. What's up, big dog? Here. He grew his dreadlocks out. Then he start wearing like militant shit. Then he started wearing like African shit, like dashikis and shit. Now, you know, in the hood, when you start wearing shit like that, people automatically outcast you. Here, you can watch Letter Factory. Yeah, when you from the hood and you start wearing stuff like that, people start outcast. Oh, look at him. He on his African shit. He an African type nigga. What you gonna sell? Some incense or something? Oh, God. Right? Probably so, John. I don't know, but Pookie really just stopped playing. He just gave up and he really got in his militant bag. Like, I'm talking about, he started wearing high boots. He started wearing, like, the cargo pants, you feel me? Like, the dashikis with the beads and all the third-eye shits. And I'm like, when we was younger, you got to think, when we was younger, we was already trained. Oh, this nigga on that Sharif shit. But our minds is already programmed. Man, he on that Sharif shit, okay? I don't want to listen to him. That's weird. Oh, God, he don't got no Jordans or no Fly Timberlands or some shit. Oh, he weird. So, when we was younger, that's how our minds was programmed. I used to always listen. I used to always pay attention to how he was moving. Oh, God, he started walking up the third. He started walking militant. Like, his whole posture changed. His whole posture changed. It went from, like that to, like, on some, like, shoulder. Peace, God. Word, God. Like, on some peace, God. He was really in his bag. Peace, God. Word is, like, on some shit like that. Like, brother. Like, he started using that word brother aggressively. Peace, brother. Like, aggressively. And I'm like, damn. Like, so that always stuck with me. I never really understood it, but it always stuck with me. It stuck with me my whole life. Like, yo. So as I got older, we all go through our stages where we like, okay, cool. Right? We go through our stages where we're like, cool. Like, I'ma listen to this other shit because that's what's popping. We all get programmed by TV. We all get programmed by radio. We all get programmed. Like, we all have a point in our life where we program, and this is the shit we listen to, and all that other shit just don't sound. It ain't right. So, when I got older, I started to go back. That was one thing I did as I got older, and as I started to progress, I started to backtrack. I started to question, hey man, wait. Let me look at some of the stuff that I was listening to and listen to what these fucking motherfuckers were saying. I started to backtrack. So I came across some older tapes that my brother and them had. I came across some older CDs that my brother and them had. I popped them things in. And I said, oh shit, Pookie was woke back in the day. He was woke. Like, I'm talking about, like, all this shit I'm talking about. All this, like, sensory deprivations and going back to the homeland and all, he was on that shit in his music. Nigga, I'm talking about 2000 something. I said, oh shit. Been on this shit. So, you grew up in the poverty area and you grew up in a lower class environment. Information is considered bad. When you grow up in a lower class environment, like this type of shit, you know what? Even when you grow up in a lower class environment, if you do anything that resembles your tribe, you get pointed out. When you do anything that resembles, man, look at him, oh God, he an African. African ass nigga, oh God, why you dressed like that, man, oh God, man, take that bunk ass shit back to the nigga, wherever you from, Zamunda, Lion King, looking at. And when you in the hood, you do anything that resembles native tribe, they gonna shoot plenty jokes on you because we've been programmed. Hey, Pumbaa and Damone, check it out. What's it is? Oh, God, he look like he about to go chill with Steve Irwin, Crocodile Hunter, look at that. They gonna shoot plenty of jokes on you. Oh God, they called you an African booty scratcher, all type of weird shit. To just, like, it was disrespectful. Like, oh, that was a thing to say. Oh God, he ugly. He looked like an African. That was a thing to say around the hood. Oh God, he ugly. Look at him. African, look at that. We was, man, they had us so distracted from what we are. They had us really hating everything about ourselves. Look, I'ma go deep. I'm my mind already racing. But even the word nigga. Look, like even when the word nigga, like that's a trap. When we say don't call us nigger or don't call us nigger, that's pretty much saying we ain't black. Like we giving up our. Oh, this is an epic reverse plot, bro. When they say don't call us nigger, and when they call you a nigger and you say don't call me nigger, they be like, yes, he don't want to be even called what he really is. Oh, it's an epic trap, bro. It's like an epic reverse psychology trap. Like, we should embrace people calling us nigger, bro. We should embrace it. Like, for real. Like, when a motherfucker be like, nigger, you should be like, okay, I know. Yes. Dog, everything is reverse psychology, bro. Everything is reverse psychology, bro. It's like it's a epic reverse psychology, bro. Look at this shit, bro. Look. So all they do is add another G to that. And that's what they calling you, bro. Look, bro, it's like, it's an epic plot. So when you say, don't call me that. When you say, don't call me a nigger, you literally giving up your rights of who you are. When you say, hey, don't call me a nigger, they be like, yes, he don't even want to be what he should be. Yes. Bro, it's an epic plot, bro. It's epic, bro. But look, I ain't even trying to go down that. I'm not even trying to go down that thing. Look, I'm keep it going. So, another epic thing they did to reverse psychology, Nimrod. When we were younger, we heard the word Nimrod. And when we heard the word Nimrod, we really thought it meant like you an idiot. When you hear the word Nimrod, you automatically think, oh, you an idiot. The whole time, Nimrod meant like a black god. The whole time. The whole time, Nimrod went, it meant you like an epic nigga. You a god. So when we was saying, don't call me a Nimrod, we low-key was casting spells on ourselves, giving up our rights. Yo, this language shit, it's an epic loop-de-loop, bro. The more and more I understand this shit, bro, but the fucked up part about it, all the information is there. Look, it's so many words. It's so many words that they have trained us and changed the context of the word. So now when we hear the word, we're completely wrong. Bro, it's, my nigga, this shit so wild, bro. This shit's so wild, bro. So, depending on how you use the word, how you use the language, will determine, like black, right? Black. Black, like, do you know there was a time in history where we didn't even want to be called black? He's like, nigga, what the fuck you talk about? I'm not black. Yo, they did this shit so long that we just finally settled with black. Like, Like, we finally settled with it. Like, it was just like, all right, we're cool. We black now. My nigga, we used to protest. Man, we ain't black. We used to protest that. Like, that was one of the early protests. We not black. Stop calling us black. Man, this shit so wild, bro. This shit wild, bro. It's so deep, but bigger than that. I want to go left field real quick. I'm going to change the whole energy. Kaepernick working out with the NFL again? I'm starting to feel bamboozled. This might have been a press run. G. I'm starting to feel bamboozled. I said I'm starting to feel bamboozled. But I'm going to tell y'all something, and this a bar. You can't never expect somebody to stand for something if you willing to kneel for something. How you expect somebody to stand for something on their knees? That don't make sense. I already knew it a long time ago. We ain't supposed to kneel to no nigga. If we standing for something, when the fuck are you supposed to bow down? Man, Kaepernick ain't even black. I don't trust you. Oh, God. I don't even know what are you. You like Arabian or something. I don't even know what are you. Gee. God. Man, all of that shit they did to him, he shouldn't even be wanting to play in the NFL. God, he should have stood his ground. Man, fuck y'all. God, I'm not about to go throw no footballs or none of that on the set. I'm out here with the people. Skid Row. You know what he should have did? He should have started a flag football lead on Skid Row. That would have been epic. Oh, God. People would have came and paid to see that. Oh, God. Some of them crackheads got wheels. God, nigga could lift a refrigerator up. You think you could tackle him? If he would have started the National Skid Row Football League. Oh, God. Can you imagine the interview? Hey, little Bucky Jones, man. How you feel about the game? Yeah, man. I just like the game. Them lost the game, let it throw the ball. Then all the man came over to the police. Oh, God, threw the ball to duck down. Oh, God. And there you have it, Bucky Jones. Yeah. He could have started the National Skid Row Football League. Oh, God, this would have been epic. Man, if he would have started the National Skid Row Football League, oh, God, this would have been epic. On the set, I would have watched every game. Tell me y'all wouldn't have watched every game. Kaepernick stars the National Skid Row Football League, oh, God. Oh, God, they going to sign him $1 million in dope. Oh, God, he signed the $1 million dope contract. Oh, God, they pay him in quarter rocks. Bucky Jones, how you feel about the game today? Man, let him come on around there, man. Oh, God, man, let him throw the ball and the football coming around there, man, the football. With a touchdown. Oh, God, this be lit. Man, I'm pulling up every day with my water, my hat, my lawn chair. Man, oh, God, go, Buggy, get it. Oh, God, they playing tackle football on concrete. They don't give no fuck. You know, crackhead skin different. That shit like shoulder pads and all that. God, they playing tackle football on clean concrete. God. The football got to be made of dope, though, God. They got to be like a solid white football, on God, they gonna play hard as a bitch. My mama, if the football is a rock, like a football, but it's like made out of dope, on God, they not missing no passes. Man, go long, Buggy, on God, Buggy gonna down. Say, hey, on God, Buggy gonna be out of here. You can't never have no hiker, though. The hiker gonna go for the run every time. Oh, God. You hike the ball to the... Damn. Say hiker. The hiker out of here trying to run to the alley. Oh, God. So the touchdown, it gotta be an alley. Like an alley on that end and an alley on that end. Oh, God. The rock, the football gotta be a dope rock. So, God, so every time they get the rock, they trying to run to the alley. Oh, God. This would be epic. My mama, this would be the most viewed. This would be the most viewed sport in mankind. That's it. Man, oh God, Bucky just signed a $4.5 million deal. Oh God, they paid him in heroin and all type of shit. Oh God, Bucky done it. Bucky, what you want to buy your kid for? Oh, reporting live, we have Bucky Jones. What do you want to buy your kid for Christmas? The TV, the VCR, the Walkman. Walkman, Bucky, it's 2020 with Bucky. I don't think they have Walkman. They don't got a Walkman. Oh, man. That's about Walkman. That's about no Walkman. Bucky. Bucky, come on over here. Man, that's about no Walkman. Man, that's about the Walkman. Man, ain't nobody out the Walkman over there, man. Oh, God. Bucky. Oh, God, bro. Crackheads be strong as a bitch. Oh, God, you ain't never tackling Bucky. Oh, God. Hey. Look, my nigga, I ain't even gonna lie. This man in the BZR, the walk man. Man, they done got the walk man over him. Oh, man. Oh, God. Hey. Oh, God, Bucky gonna be mad he don't get a walk bed. Man, not the bottom of my was a walk, man. Man, oh, man. Oh, God, the crackheads go. Oh, God. Man, I've been downtown for years. I used to be down there. Oh, God, I know exactly how they sound. Bucky Jones, a real person. I'm not capping at all. He down. He on fourth right now. I could go straight to fourth. Oh, just said I could go straight to four of his tent right there. Bucky, check it out. What do I mean to walk, man? Oh, God. There's no cap. We could go downtown L.A. right now, 4th and Central. Bucky right there. Oh, God. Man, oh, my God. I bet the walk, man. Oh, God. That's all Bucky ever talk about, the walk bed. Look, my mama. Look, you know, San Pedro, oh, God, Central, oh, God, man. Some of them hang off Alameda all the way down, oh, God. Wall, oh, God, man, what? Bucky running back, oh, God. He out of here, man, Bucky gone. Bucky gonna do all type of jukes, oh, God. Look, my nigga, I'm keeping it all the way real with y'all. If Kaepernick would have started that football league for the National Homeless Football League, oh, God, he could have had the little park, got him a little park. Oh, God, if he would have got him a little park, and, man, crackhead be buff as a bitch. Oh, God, they different. Man, you don't go downtown. You don't understand. Oh, God, these niggas built to live through all terrain. This is different. Oh, God. They be out there 2 degrees dancing. These different type of creatures. Oh, God. Kaepernick could have got him a little park downtown somewhere. Oh, God. Made a little small little stadium. It wouldn't took too much. Oh, God. Made a little small little stadium, little dome. Oh, God. Hold about 400 people, 500 people. Oh, God. He could have made the National Homeless Football League. Oh, God. Start running back. Bucky Jones. Okay. Check it out. How you feel today, Bucky? Yeah, let the man love, man. Let the man a good day. Yeah, what you gonna do today, Bucky? How much you gonna score, man? Let the man love, let the man a touchdown. Man, let the walk, man. Oh, God. This would be, I'll be crying. Oh, God, nobody getting tackled. Crackhead strong as a bitch. Oh, God, you ever see the old crackheads fighting? Oh, God, the fight be in full slow-mo. I thought they filmed in 3,000 frames per second. Oh, God, he talking about, man, what job? Oh, God, the nigga get hit, too. Wham! Oh, he going down. He going down. Oh, God, it be the longest fall a nigga ever seen. Oh, God. Oh God, he be falling. Man, I remember one time a nigga got hit. Oh God, we went to the store and came back. He was still on his way down. God. Oh God, a crackhead, man. Hey, I'm gonna keep it real with y'all. Other than the times that I used to be down there doing things that I regret. When I say regret, I don't necessarily mean selling drugs. I mean, I had like a little crackhead piece that I used to fuck with. I ain't even gonna lie to a nigga. Oh God, she had ass. But don't judge me. You feel me? Don't judge me. Everybody have their, you know, their things. Don't judge me. Said I thought I could change her. I thought I could change her life. I thought wrong. Oh God, I thought wrong. I had me a little piece down there. I used to go see, check up on her, bring her water and all that. Oh God. Gosh. I remember one time I was doing some illegal business and I was like, man, you don't need to be doing this. Oh God. You could buy this last one. Oh God, because I need the 10. But you don't need to be doing this, man. I'm going to help you get off of this. So I was gradually, I used to sell her about 3-4 rocks a day. So I went from 3-4 rocks to 2. Oh God, I went to 1. She was cleaning up. Oh God. She was like, you know, I just need my fix for the day. Just 1, I'll be good. Oh God, I was cleaning her up gradually. God, then I went from 1 rock to 0.5 a rock. Oh God. I got her clean, man. She just started smoking cigarettes. Oh God, you good? How you doing? Oh God, cleaned her up. God, I must have went on tour, came back. Oh God, man, where she at? Man, she over there in the 10. I went in the 10. Oh God, she went back down to 10 rocks. It was over. Man, what you doing in there? Oh God. Couldn't save her, G. God, she had a tent full of VCRs. I said, oh yeah, it's over. But anywho, on some real shit, like, wait, hey, y'all, I'm about to restart this live real quick. Y'all, make sure y'all tune back in. Make sure everybody tune back in. So just, if you don't see me live, just click on the thing anyway, because I'm going to be in there.